In this tutorial, we will explore Thea materials inside the Attribute Manager, and we will start with a first look at the material scheme. Thea render materials are physically based, meaning that the models used obey the physical laws and they have been developed based on an analytical physical framework. The material system consists of 5 reflectance models that you can see to the right. Let us have a look at them one by one. The basic substrate is perfect for matte, plastic and even metal materials, since it has been designed as a highly energy-conserving material. Translucency along with the absorption can be used to create a fast subsurface scattering effect. Materials that can be created with a basic substrate are plastics, leaves, curtains and many more. Moving on to the glossy substrate. The glossy substrate has been designed to simulate reflection and refraction. This reflectance model uses complex index of refraction values that can be used to create perfect metals. Therefore, glossy substrate is mostly used for simulating metals and glass. The next one is the SSS substrate. The SSS substrate is based on the glossy layer but with subsurface scattering enabled. Next in the list is the thin film substrate. The thin film substrate is perfect for thin surfaces like windows, transparent plastics and bubbles. Finally, we have coating. Coating is a special reflection model that has only specular component. It is often being used for simulating varnish and paints over layered materials, such as wooden floors and car paint. Let us move on to the global properties that we see on the left of the material scheme. In general properties, the user can define basic material attributes. The next two icons, clipping and displacement, are also called geometric modifiers. Clipping using textures to cut through geometry based on a given texture, and it is often used to create leaves and labels amongst others. Displacement uses textures to displace the geometry along its normals, with additional settings for the control and quality of the displaced surface. The next icon is the emitter. The emitter property can be used to create area lights when applied to surfaces, and even create IES lights. The last global property is the medium. With medium, the user can achieve true volumetric scattering. In the next section, we will create simple materials using layers and combinations of them. Starting with the basic substrate, we will create a translucent plastic material. At first, we need to define a color, and to do that, we should go to the diffuse channel and click on the first icon to enable the color picker. After selecting a color, we can add some reflection by using the color picker and apply a white color to it. As you can see, we now have a shiny plastic material that only needs some translucency. And to do that, we will copy the diffuse color to the translucent channel. We could also add some roughness to the model surface with a slight increase in the roughness channel. Moving on to the glossy layer, we will create a glass and a metal material. Starting with glass, we just need to add reflection and transmittance to the shader by adding a color to both channels. Let's duplicate this material and apply it to the other object. By defining a color for absorption and changing its value, we can give color to our glass material. For the metal material, we will increase reflection by changing the color in the reflectance channel. Now to give it the metal look, we need to use real data in the IOR fields. For this example, we're going to create a silver material. Let's also increase roughness to see the difference. The thin film substrate is often being used in thin, transparent surfaces like plastics, windows and more. Thin film has transmittance enabled by default, so you can see how it looks right away. There is also the interference parameter, which can be used to create a bubble effect. The next material is the subsurface scattering. The basic parameters that control its appearance are absorption and scattering. We will give them both a bright color and increase their values to make the material look more dense. As you will notice, the two gears, while they have the same material, they do look different, and this has to do with their thickness, which plays an important role in the overall effect of the SSS material. Creating a metallic paint material requires the combination of two substrates. The first one is the paint itself, with an increased value of roughness and reflection, while the other one is the varnish that gives the final glossy look. So, firstly, we create a basic substrate and change its color and reflection. We will also change the NK values to increase the reflection. The last thing is to change roughness to a value of 35%. Having created the basic layer of the paint, we can add a coating substrate, which will give us the look of varnish. To create a leaf material, we will first need to create the basic substrate with translucency, reflection and roughness. So let's begin by assigning leaf texture and the diffuse channel. Let's also add some reflection to the material. We will copy the leaf texture from the diffuse to the translucency channel. After increasing the roughness of the material, we're ready to go on with clip mapping. Let's enable clipping first. Using a black and white image in the clipping channel, we create the cut-out effect that we want. Let's see how to create displacement using textures and a basic substrate. We will first assign the texture in the diffuse channel. Let's also add some reflection to the material and increase roughness. Now it is time to enable displacement. We're going to use a grayscale and blurry version of the previous texture. We can control the final look of the displacement by changing the height and subdivision values. Emitters can be created without the need of having a substrate. We can start by creating a new material and enabling the emittance property. Use the power and the efficacy values to control the overall emittance of the material. In this scene, we will learn how to create volumetric lights. It is a simple setup with one area light and an object to cast shadows. What you need to know here is that we also need to create a container for the medium, and for that we have created a box in the scene and we will apply to it a material with medium. So let's create a new material and apply to the container. We will now enable medium from the global properties. After giving a bright color to absorption and scattering, we will also need to lower their values. The important thing to know here is that the camera must always be outside of the medium container, otherwise you will not be able to see the volumetric effect. Apart from the fact that you can create your own materials, it is also possible to use material presets. They can be found at the Thea menu in the Material tab. This is how these presets look by default. They should be used as a starting point for quick material setups. Another way to quickly apply materials is by using the Thea Content Browser. It can be accessed from Cinema 4D's Content Browser. Double-click on Presets and select the Thea Materials folder. From here you can drag and drop any material to the scene. This concludes our Thea Materials overview inside Cinema 4D. Thank you for watching.